What up, guys? I'm Tahir Moore.
And I'm Patrick Cloud.
And this is another episode of Lunchtime Lottery.
Yeah. And I'm hungry. So, you guys know what the show is already. We order random meal from Postmates.
Yep.
And then we wait for it to get here, we eat it, and then we rate it.
Yeah, I'm with that.
But today's a little special. We have a special edition for you guys. Today we are going to pair whatever food we order with a movie or television show.
Because, I mean, let's be honest, man. That's when you're doing it. That's when you have the best food, is when you're watching something good, you got company, mm-hmm. or you're just chilling by yourself. But a good movie, a good show pairs well with food. I'm all about it.
Mm-hmm. We're going to get the perfect meal,
mm-hmm.
and then we're just going to talk about the perfect piece of entertainment. Y'all down for like a little movie or show review or memory?
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, let's go ahead and get it.
It's the same way you pair a good wine with a meal. I feel like that. Mm-hmm. It's like pairing a good movie with a meal.
A good Postmates. Oh, this is a good year of Postmates. speaking of a good year, well, that's not really speaking of a good year.
No.
Speaking of cups that hold things, this has all of our cuisines or genres, if we will. We've been calling it genres because I don't know about you, but I hear music when I eat.
So. Yeah. I just don't know what else to call like cuisine. Selections of food.
Cuisine. I like genre.
But you I like genres. Know. Genres of cuisine.
Genres of cuisine. Oh, that's better. Yeah. I like that. All right. Well, today's genre of cuisine. Breakfast.
Hey, come on now.
Breakfast. What's your favorite breakfast food?
I love a good breakfast sandwich. I love a good breakfast burrito.
Breakfast burritos sound fire.
I love it.
All right, so we are going to open up the good old Postmates app.
Mm-hmm.
Once again, big shout out to our sponsor, Postmates.
Ratatata. Those were shout outs.
Which is great because I use them religiously. All right, so I just pulled up a spot called LA Breakfast Club.
I'm with it. Already, it's got two things I like, LA and breakfast.
LA Breakfast Club, you sold already. Okay, it's pretty interesting. Okay, this is kind of cool. So every entree or meal that they have is based on Los Angeles in some way. So there are breakfast burritos. One's called the Venice. One's called the Melrose. One's called the Arts District. Then there's breakfast sandwiches. One's called the Skate Park, the Palm Tree, and the It's Always Sunny.
Okay. I feel like the Always Sunny has a lot of eggs in it, and I feel like the Arts District might be a little messy. Just basing it.
Somewhat right. Then there's an LA breakfast bowl called the Post Yoga. It doesn't get more LA of a menu than this.
Wow, Post Yoga.
So it's looking like the options are bacon, egg, and cheese, egg, sausage, and cheese, and then egg and cheese.
Let me ask you a question.
And then everything is crazy around that.
Which do you prefer, bacon or sausage?
I'm not gonna lie, I prefer both, but I would probably get. I like sausage better.
Me too.
And it's bacon has been super popular. I love bacon, so that's not the popular answer to say.
Yeah.
But I've always been, I don't want to say team sausage, but
I mean it is what it is. I prefer sausage patties over links. I prefer both bacon and sausage, but if I can only pick one, I'm gonna go sausage. I feel like you get more bang for your buck. I love bacon. I think it's a great addition to things. It's a great feature on the track. You know what I'm saying? Like, bacon comes on and make that track fire. Something that was already flames, it makes it even more fire.
Bacon however, is a good feature.
Yeah, however, by itself, though, like, you know, you get a bacon sandwich, you usually only get, like, two pieces of bacon. It's like, that's not enough for my bite. When I get a bite, I want all the meat. Don't make it weird, bro.
I'm not going to make it weird.
Don't make it weird. I just all the meat.
I just agreed. Okay, so... I'm going to go ahead and get a breakfast burrito.
No. I'm going to pick the breakfast burrito for you. If that's the case, we're going to keep it like that. I'm going to pick it for you.
Okay. Well, then I'm going to pick you a breakfast sandwich because they got pictures.
Okay. Pictures always help. I love when companies have pictures because, man, picking blindly is just like, I hope this is good.
Right. All right. Well, since you said that you prefer sausage over bacon, I'm not going to do you wrong. I'm going to get you the Palm Tree, which is basically an egg, sausage, and cheese sandwich with two scrambled eggs, LA breakfast chorizo, melty Monterey Jack cheese on a wavy torta bread with salsa.
Sounds fire.
Sounds
with
pretty good.
I'm with it.
And I got the Venice.
Okay. All right.
You got a sandwich. Why don't you hook me up with a breakfast burrito?
I might. Let's see.
Please don't give me the post yoga.
That's what I should do. It's just because you don't want it. But I'm going to be a good person today. The Venice is the egg, bacon, and cheese breakfast burrito. Delicious burrito with 2 scrambled eggs, sugar glazed bacon, melty. Oh, that sounds pretty fire. Sounds pretty fire. Okay.
Did it let you add a little extra?
It says special instructions, so I guess you can. And yeah, it says deck it out.
Why don't we throw a little some tots in there?
Some tater tots. I do that. I'm gonna get you the Venice, and I'm gonna throw some tots in there.
The Venice.
Yeah.
That's the bacon one, right?
Yeah.
Okay. The Venice. All right, so we got the Venice and the palm tree.
Yeah.
It doesn't get more L.A. than that.
It doesn't. This is actually all of, and there's a lot of palm trees in Venice, so all over L.A. to be fair, but Venice too. So, okay. Yeah, go ahead and do that right there.
All
right,
so let's send this order in, and the delivery driver on the flying bike should be here soon.
You know what I like
the
most about everything that's been going on?
Mm.
The fact that we still have essential workers, people to still like handle stuff that we can't do or necessarily don't want to do.
Right.
Like, for instance, just going to get your food. Like, something as simple as this, like, yeah, we could have went to get it, but then we had to cut and food might be all of that type of stuff.
Driving.
Like, all of that, man. So I'm so thankful for all the essential workers and even Postmates.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because Postmates is a company that provides you with all the food, drink, and not just food and drink, but also essential needs. Like, you can Postmate stuff from Walgreens, you can Postmate stuff from CVS, from 7-Eleven, and I don't think they get enough shout out for that, man. So shout out to y'all, man. Shout out to all the drivers and Postmates, and we appreciate what y'all do, because it's a lot.
What's the most, like, non-conventional thing that you've ever had Postmated to your house? Like, not just like a meal, like...
Yeah. Not gonna lie. this is gonna make me sound weak as hell. But
okay.
Had a hangnail, right? Realized we had just moved. We must have lost the container with all the Band-Aids in it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, I'm gonna Postmate this.
Okay.
And I literally Postmated some Band-Aids.
A Band-Aid.
The box of it. I wanted to make sure it was worth it. So I got the whole big family thing. They got one. They got this one big box that comes with like five different boxes of Band-Aids in it.
Mm-hmm.
Like all different sizes. They had the Mickey Mouse one and all that type of stuff. But yeah, that was the most random thing I've ever Postmated.
Okay. I think it's not too random, but liquor.
Yes.
Liquor was great because, it was already like a drinking situation. I didn't want to drive.
Yeah.
And a lot of people think that Postmate is just like get a burger to me or some sushi. Yeah. But
so much more.
Yeah, you could, and it was liquor and toothpaste. That's why that one was what was random. It was the combination. It was liquor, and then it was like I also need toothpaste, so I just had them. Get both like, of
all
it.
Right, you're gonna have a crazy night and an early morning.
Exactly, but I mean, if you're like us, you start thinking of the next meal while you're eating. I mean, I'm thinking about dinner during lunch. I'm thinking about lunch during breakfast.
Yeah,
always thinking about food. And sometimes getting into the kitchen and cooking is just not the move.
It's a hassle.
It's not something that you're trying to do.
Doing it.
And that's why we've been loving Postmates.
Yeah.
Okay. With Postmates, you can get your food delivered without leaving the house.
Yep.
Or even opening the front door.
Yeah.
With the current state of the world, Postmates created no contact deliveries. So now when I order from local restaurants, everything gets left on the doorstep and the app lets me know when it's been delivered, which is actually great for me because I'm terrible with ordering Postmates and then putting my phone down and like missing the call, or I'm terrible with that. I miss the call.
He really is.
But now it's like I'll go out there and they just leave it right there tied
Perfect.
Up, nice little bow, a little thank you note.
Everything has the seals now too. It makes you feel a lot better now that, and I feel like company should have been doing that. But I love the safety seals now on the staple to bag clothes. Like even the drinks have like the safety seal over.
Right.
So I'm loving it, bro.
Yeah.
I'm all about it. So you guys need to get on this.
But you don't have to get it delivered. They also have a pickup option, which we've been using just to order takeout from local restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
And what's the coolest thing about Postmates is the promotion. People don't really talk about that because Postmates is really like good promotion. I'm eating at restaurants I would have never just stopped at,
just, yeah.
or like parked my car and just said, let me check this place out. But yeah. It's really like good.
The
for,
suggest as soon as you launch it, it was like near you. You were like, oh, then I yeah. give you the popular item. Oh,
you have no idea. It's like, did I even live in this neighborhood? but yeah, you can get it, you know, for pickup. Mm. And you know, like we were saying before, you can order anything like toilet paper, phone chargers, anything from Walgreens, 7-Eleven. It's not just food. Mm. They will bring anything to the front door.
That is.
Yep. And you can get it from anywhere. You can get it on iOS or Android. Mm-hmm. Find your favorites and get anything you want delivered within the hour. Just download Postmates. Mm-hmm. Okay. And for a limited time, we're going to hook you up. Postmates is giving our listeners $5 off of your first 5 orders that for is. Your first 7 days. So if you're brand new to the Postmates game, for that first week,
mm-hmm.
you will get $5 off of your first 5 orders.
Thanks.
We're gonna call it the 5-5-7 deal. $5 off your first 5 orders for the first 7 days. And to save $5 on your first 5 deliveries, just download the app and mm-hmm. use our code SCARYLUNCH.
Yeah, it is.
SCARYLUNCH. There was weird pauses in there because I had to I had to think about the spelling. but once again, that's the code SCARYLUNCH for $5 mm-hmm. off of your first 5 orders when you download Postmates app or sign up online.
That is.
Anything you need, Postmate it.
All right, Pat went to go grab our food, and then we're going to jump right into this L.A. breakfast. You know what I'm talking about? Ready to get it going. And I haven't eaten all day today, so it's a true representation of my hunger. Dessert.
Safely stapled.
Yeah, man.
As always.
Yeah. That's real. They got that. Yeah. Better you than somebody else.
Yeah, this is true. Well, might as well, you know?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Ooh, this has got some weight on it.
All right, so we got these green sauce, ketchup, salt if you need it.
Now
what is this?
Tots.
Tots, okay.
Yeah.
So they gave it to us on the side.
Yeah, oh, this is.
Throw it in there.
This
oh, wow.
This is healthy right here.
That's hefty. That is a hefty portion.
Yeah. Lean on that.
It's a hefty portion. Let me see what I'm working with. It's just going to look like a burrito. Yeah. You're going to have to. I'll show you when it's. Sliced open.
I'm gonna cut this in. This is aggressive, so I'm gonna just.
It's very aggressive. It's almost like a sloppy Joe.
Yeah, it's a lot of chorizo on it. Didn't realize it's gonna be so much.
All right, so we got avocado.
Mm-hmm.
There are some tots in here.
Got the tots in there.
Egg, bacon.
Okay. Breakfast burrito. Ketchup for this young tots.
Wow. That's a good burrito.
We good?
Mm-hmm.
The tots are a little light-skinned. A little light-skinned, but honestly, I would prefer them to not be as crispy than to be overburnt. Or overcooked, rather. I'm going to get a piece of this real quick.
Mm-hmm. It's like a top boulder.
Mm.
Yeah. These need to be crispier.
Mm-hmm. Man. That's good.
That's all what, chorizo?
Mm-hmm. I think chorizo, sausage, egg, Monterey Jack, guacamole. And I asked for a little mayo, so they got a little mayo on there. I think a little salsa. It's kind of spicy, too. Got a little kick to it.
Nice. I really like how they like the eggs. They're so fluffy.
Mm. I like the bun, too.
This is the best breakfast burrito I've had in a while.
This sandwich would make me very unproductive the rest of the day. You know what I'm saying?
That's okay. It's worth it.
This reminds me of...
I'm a girl that you once knew.
It reminds me of, Saturday mornings when I first moved out here. I wasn't working nearly as much, so Saturdays were kind of like my chill day.
Mm-hmm.
and I would get up early and watch Law and Order SVU. Because if we're being honest, SVU is it's the one. Let's be honest.
Bum bum.
Dun 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 dun. And like, I would get up early because they would start the marathons around 8 or 9 on USA, and I would watch Law and Order SVU on USA. And like, this would be something I would do. I would order something, if I didn't feel like going to get it, come back and camp out on the couch and figure out who the killer was while Detective Benson and Stabler were out there in the streets, the cohort streets of New York. And this is something that I would do. This pairs well with that.
Law and Order,
mm-hmm.
SVU.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a specific season or moment that sticks out?
I don't know if there's one per se. Because SVU was just fire, man. Like, I love the cliffhangers. I will say that I like when they did solve the case, and I like when they, you know, they handed down the decision in the trial. Mm-hmm. I hate when they used to leave it on them just going to court and they found the killer and then it just shows them going to court and then Dick Wolf comes up. His name comes up. Dick Wolf has made a lot of stuff too, by the way.
Hmm.
A lot of stuff.
Was he the writer?
Yeah, creator. Writing creator of Law and Order. But yeah.
Law and Order is such a good show, like
long running too.
I never really like sat down and was like, I'm a Law and Order fan,
mm-hmm.
but I've seen it so many times and I've enjoyed it every time.
Law and Order has a huge following, man. And I love now that like the episodes now are pulling from cases that we've seen in the news. Like they've had all type of cases on there. The whole Ray Rice thing, the whole Chris Brown thing, gaming, all of that type of stuff, bro. Like everything has been, for the most part, addressed on Law and Order, man. And it's cool to see it from another view. You know what I mean? Like, oh man, I remember when that happened and them pull from that. And they don't make it exactly the same, but it's kind of cool to see the spin on it that they do.
Hmm. Yeah, I definitely. Ice. That's not the one that Ice-T's in, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep, that's hot.
That is, it's the funniest part about that show by far.
Ice-T made a song called So Many Things Against the Police, and now he is actually
Wasn't it Cop Killer or something?
I forgot which one it was. That's why I didn't want to say it, because I didn't want to pull my phone out and have to look.
Yeah, I totally forgot what it was. But yeah, that is ironic, but he didn't just have like a guest spot. Like he's like a legit cast member now.
Yeah. And he's only had a couple episodes where he was like the main character, like the one with his son. There were a couple with his son that he was on, and he got like more camera time than everybody else. Every other episode, he's kind of been like supporting. He's always been around Stabler and Benson, and then Cragen, who was the captain. And then when Cragen retired and Stabler left, it was just Benson, and she became the lieutenant. So it was dope, though.
You don't remember any like cases that you were like, man, that was pretty messed up, or like favorite episodes?
Yes. Let me see. One of my favorite episodes was, they were looking for, I was just going to say that, a killer. And I was like, that's literally every episode. Literally every episode.
Most of them.
there's so many. I'm trying to think of one, just narrow it down.
I feel like I remember one specifically. It was like this kid walking to school. It was this white dude. And it was this kid that was walking to school, and he was just like kidnapped in broad day.
Mm.
And then I was just like, that was like the cold open. Like, yeah. I was like, dang, the show didn't even start yet. And I just saw a full kidnapping. And that must have been the first one I saw, because all of them do that.
Oh, you know what? Here's one. There was two young girls. They were at a party. They were underage. And one of them had got kidnapped. And her homegirl couldn't find her. And the cops got involved. And they found her phone. And it had video footage of her in the car with some random guy or some guy that she had met at the club.
Mm.
But they were setting him up to make it look like he did it. Mm-hmm. They had put blood in the car and on something that was in the car, and I think maybe at this place or something like that.
Okay.
But it was all a ruse, because she was in town with like I think the band director or something like that. And so she had snuck away with him. But he came up to the police station like he was really trying to help and stuff like that. And the mom was just kind of like shady towards him. And the dad didn't know what was going on. So he's just like, I need to find my daughter. Y'all need to find my daughter. Comes to light that the band director had been sleeping with the daughter, right? And they had went up to a house up in upper New York and all of that. But here's the craziest part. The band director had slept with the mom years ago. And the girl he was sleeping with was actually his daughter. And the dad didn't know, the mom didn't know, but the band director didn't know. So it was like, wow. That was one of my favorite episodes of Law and Order. That I can't remember which one it was, but that
like
one.
An episode you should pair with liquor.
Woo!
Man. That sounds like a rough one.
That's one you just eating the sandwich, you just like, whoa.
What?
That was a lot.
That's a lot to process. Wow.
Yeah. What about you?
You know, I feel like a funny one for me would be a show that I used to watch when I pretended to be sick and, you know, stayed home from school. And that is one of the most memed celebrities in internet culture's first show, or their biggest show, Chuck Norris's Walker, Texas Ranger.
Whoa, you used to watch Walker, Texas Ranger?
I did. Super random. It's one of the earliest memories that I have in television. Because, that show is old.
It is.
But it was dope to me. And it was like, I want to say it was on regular TV, so it wasn't like crazy violent.
I'm going to say like CBS, I think.
Something like that. And Chuck Norris is just like, I mean, he's super cool, but his fighting style is just so uninteresting. It's very
American.
Karate, block, hit. So it wasn't crazy violent. So, you know, my parents let me watch that. And it was the closest thing I got to a Western. You know, like, I feel like the generations before me always had, like, childhood stories about like watching Clint Eastwood and like all these Westerns and like riding like a little wooden stupid horse toy. But yeah, that was like my version of a Western, and I was like a huge Chuck Norris fan. It was Walker, Texas Ranger, and Xena. You remember Xena?
Oh yeah, Xena the Warrior Princess.
Yeah, that was like the era, but like I feel like that was my first era of TV.
Yeah, Xena and Hercules. I remember both of them. And Hercules was just like a plain looking guy on that show. Like, I feel like they had one crossover episode, but he was just a plain looking dude.
He wasn't like buffer than the next.
No, not at all, man. Like, he wasn't even like Arnold Schwarzenegger buff, but
I don't really remember him being tall, actually.
I don't know how tall he was because I never like stood next to him, or like I never made a reference of anyone he was standing next to. But yeah, man, it was not impressive. But when you're watching that, we didn't have cable a lot growing up, so I just was like, yeah, Xena, she's bad.
Xena was a better show, than the Hercules version.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Was it Hercules? Was it actually called?
Yeah, it was just Hercules. Was? Yeah.
Dang.
I think it was Hercules or Legend of Hercules, but Xena was like the Laura Croft before Laura Croft.
Yeah.
For sure.
Or she was almost like Wonder Woman without the powers.
She was doing all of that in a skirt, too. Just want to remind
you. In a skirt
you.
And a blouse that had armor on it. It was like, it was still like very womanly, but it was like sword proof.
Some boots. She had boots or sandals. Either way.
All those shows had like the same grainy 90s feel. Yeah.
Woo, 90s and, cinema and shows.
Yes.
Highlander.
I would
Xena,
be
Hercules.
Killing the Tostino's pizza rolls.
Oh,
and,
those,
and that's what I was pairing with those shows at that time in my life. The pizza rolls and the bagel bites.
Oh.
The bagel
Actually,
bites.
Actually, that was kind of fancy. We never got the bagel bites. We got some Tostinos, but we never got the bagel bites. That was a little fancy for us.
Bagel bites were hit and miss.
Yeah.
Because the bagel, if it was done right and it was toasted, it was fire. But like if it was like rubbery and like
throw the whole tray away.
The pizza kind of like where the pizza sat weird on it and it kind of like smeared off. Yeah. You just got a tomato bagel. It could get bad.
It could get bad real fast.
But then, you know, the Tostinos would give you third degree burns in your mouth.
Oh yeah, easy. You bite into that liquid shooting roof of your mouth. Yeah, now you're not
eating watching Pokemon without even touching your tongue to the sides of your mouth. You're just like, wait, which one is that one?
Then that skin start falling at the top. You know what? Forget it. I'm done.
Ouch.
Do you remember a favorite episode of you didn't say Xena, you said
Walker. No. I don't remember a plot line. I don't remember another character. I just remember when I stayed home, it was Walker, Xena, and like those judge shows. There's so many court shows.
All of them are staged too. I found that out recently when I saw some of my friends on there.
There's so many all deaf people in court shows. It's wild. There's probably some court show out there with me in the back in the audience as a guest. I was an extra on a court show, and that's when I was like, I thought we were gonna be going to a court, but no, it was a sound stage, and basically you see all those wooden walls you see around the judge end as soon as the camera ends. Like it's literally like a half court in a soundstage with probably two other courts in it. It's
Hollywood magic, strange. Man. That Hollywood magic. They made you really think they was in that courtroom. They were not.
And they were not trying to leave no paper trail with the extras. There's 100 cash. Everybody just lined up on the way out like cattle. And they're just like, don't talk to me.
Oh, my just God. I did background, I think, for a game show. And the game show probably was the worst, man, because they didn't want you to leave to go to the bathroom. Like, everybody had to go to the bathroom at the same time, because when the cameras come back on, you have to be in the same seat and all of that. It was the worst. I will never do background like that again.
It was a great way to see everything, but it's just, it was not fun.
It was not fun at all.
The worst was talking to the bougie extras. Who talked about all the other things they were extras on. Just like, I work here all the time. I was an extra in Fresh Prince. I was in the back of the Jeopardy. I was in the back of this. I was in the back of this. It's like, yo, you need to chill.
Cool, man. Cool. That's
you
what's
up,
bro.
You need to chill. But yeah, that was definitely my daytime breakfast, like, shows right there.
Yeah. All right. Well, cool, man. Well, listen, it's time we rate this, man. How are you feeling about L.A. breakfast?
Let's get back to the burrito. Mm-hmm. Breakfast burritos don't stand a chance once they cooled off.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So that first half of that burrito was fire.
Yeah.
Burrito placement is very important because you just get random bites.
Mm-hmm.
And this one, I could tell the egg was wrapped around almost just like the tortilla was. It was like a little mini burrito in there. Mm-hmm. And they put like the bacon right in the middle. There's so much avocado and potatoes. Perfect. It was very, very good. So but then once it cooled off, I kind of checked out. So I am going to give the burrito, the Venice, an 8.5.
Okay. All right, cool. I like the sandwich. It was good. It's kind of the same thing with the burrito, though. Like, once breakfast has cooled down, period, like, it just kind of it changes the vibe of it, unless you're starving. You know what I'm saying? This was really good. I'm not a huge fan of chorizo. I thought it was going to be more sausage than chorizo. And this was definitely, like, a lot of chorizo. A little more salty than I particularly like. But I like the bread. I like how big it was. I like the egg. The egg was good. And I'm a big fan of cheese, so the Monterey on there was fire.
Okay.
But like I said, just a little salty for my taste.
Okay,
so based on that, I'm going to give it a 7.
7?
Yeah, okay, give it a 7. Because it was still flavorful. It was mad flavorful.
And just for giggles, the Tots. Why don't you give the Tots a rating?
Oh, the Tots going to get a hard 5, bro. A hard 5.
I'm going to give the Tots a 3.
Yeah, they were. Like I said, I would prefer them be that rather than too crispy. Mm-hmm. However, I feel like those were just, they weren't it. Like they didn't keep those down long enough.
I like how Tots are getting more representation in like real restaurants now.
I love Tots.
I do too. Like, actual fancy restaurants will give you some Tots.
And I love it.
If you go to like a public school or something like that, their Tots are very crispy, almost like French fry crispy. But I don't mind them. I usually don't like you said, crispy Tots. But like, the restaurant quality ones are really fire, and it's hard to go back to.
I had
elementary school version.
So if you're ever in the LA area, the Valley area, make sure you check out LA Breakfast Club. You will not be disappointed. You already know two things on the menu that we've already rated. It's definitely something I would go back to. Like, if I had to be up here another day and shooting early, I would definitely order back from LA Breakfast Club because it was solid.
But once again, huge shout out to our sponsor, Postmates, as always. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. Let us know if you've ever hit up LA Breakfast Club before or what your favorite type of breakfast sandwich or burrito is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
As always, I've been Patrick Cloud.
And I'm to hear more. We'll see you on the next meal.
Later, peace, guys.